In this video, I'm going to show you how to use Premiere Pro to add this style of dynamic captions to your YouTube Shorts, your Instagram Reels, and your TikTok videos. So let's go over to Premiere Pro. Here I have a new project. I'm going to start by creating my sequence. Just hover your mouse to this project media section, right click, then new item, and then sequence. I'll just name my sequence, maybe captions, and then come over to sequence settings. Here, I'm going to change the frame size to 1080 by 1920 since it is a vertical video. Every other thing can be the same for me. I'm going to click on OK. The next step is to import the clip I want to work on. So I'll right click this area again, click on import. This is the clip I want to use. Select it and then click on import and then just drag the clip to my timeline. To make the tracks bigger, I'll just double click each of them. And then also to maximize my space, since this is a vertical video, I can just come over to window and then workspaces and then select vertical. That'll give us this layout that is just perfect when working with vertical videos. Now to add the captions to this video, what you just want to do is come over to text. You see text at the top here. So under text, you want to click on create transcription, select the language, which is basically the language in the video. Then speaker labeling, no, we don't want to do that. Audio analysis, just select audio on track and then click on transcribe. Once you click on transcribe, in just a matter of seconds, Premiere Pro is going to automatically transcribe your video for you. You don't have to do any manual typing. And you can see just like that, we have a full transcript of our video right here. But before we go ahead and add this transcript as captions to our video, we need to do some basic editing because the transcription is not always 100% accurate. There will be some mistakes and there will be some corrections you need to do before you actually add it to your video. So I'm going to start the editing by removing all the full stops because I don't want full stops in my caption. So just type in full stop in this search box here and then click on this replace icon because what we actually want to do is to remove the full stops. This replace with section is going to be blank and then just click on replace all. That'll remove all the full stops in your transcript. I'm going to repeat this same process for commas as well. So no full stops and commas, except if you want to have those punctuation marks on your captions. Now I'll just go through my transcript line by line and make sure that everything is correct. For instance, if I start playing, 99% of people actually here, we are supposed to have a before the actually. So it's supposed to be 99% of people are actually using ChatGPT the wrong way. So this is basically what you want to do. Play through your timeline while double checking the transcript. Then go ahead and correct those points that need to be corrected. This is the most time consuming part of the whole process, but the clip I have here is less than 90 seconds long. It should not take too long. So right now I'm going to take time to go through my transcript to make sure that everything is correct before we continue. So I am done editing my transcript. The next step is to add it as captions to our video. And to do that, just click on this CC icon at the top, which stands for Create Captions. If I click on it, then click on Preferences. This is where you get to set some basic parameters for your captions. So format, subtitles, style, I've just used none. Your major concern at this stage will be the maximum length in characters. I like to reduce this to like maybe 20 characters so that we have just 1 to 2 words per caption. The longer the maximum length in characters you have, the more words you are going to have on each caption. So I'm going to make it 20 or 21. Then maximum duration in seconds, I'm going to reduce this to about 1.2 seconds, which is the least. And then gap between captions, just leave this at zero. Then how many lines do you want for your captions? I'm going to use single line, depending on the one you prefer. Then once you've set all of this, go ahead and click on create captions. Now you can see that our caption has been added to our video. And if we play through right here, you're going to see the captions down here. The captions we have look very basic. It's not exactly what you want to have. So to apply styling to your captions, I'm going to select everything, right? Just hold your mouse at the end, then drag over all of them, and then come over to Essential Graphics, then click on Edit. And basically, you want to come over to the text section, select the font you want to use. I'm going to use Montserrat Black Italic, and then you can select the alignment style you want to use for your text. Here also, you can adjust the font size. Let's say I'm going to use somewhere around 70 or maybe 75. Then I'm going to use all caps by clicking on this double T. So that'll turn our text into all caps. Then the alignment, I want to have my text somewhere close to the middle. So select the middle zone and then just kind of drag the vertical alignment down a little bit. I'm going to try something like 300 or maybe 400. So I think I'm cool with where it is right now. When you are creating short videos, maybe YouTube Shorts, Instagram Reel, or TikToks, you don't want to have your captions way too down because the video windows of these platforms have text and other stuff that can cover it up. Then for the appearance, you can get to select the color of your text, but I'm going to use white for now. Also, you can add stroke. I'm not going to add stroke, but I'm going to add background. So I'm going to select background color. I'm going to use something like maybe this and then click OK. I'm going to make the green lighter. So I'll just, okay, I'm going to work with this. Then you can adjust the transparency of your background. Also, you can adjust the spread by dragging this slider. I'm going to use something like 50 for the spread. Then also you can adjust the border radius of your background. 40 is okay. You can basically play around with all of this till you get exactly what you want. I'm not going to touch the shadow. Let's say I'm cool with the way it is right now. And as you can see, now we have this cool captions added to our video. And this is going to make our video more engaging to viewers. Now, you can decide to take it a step further if you want to add animations to your captions. Let's say you want them to pop or flip around or whatever. You can just highlight everything again, come over to where you have graphics and titles, and then click on upgrade caption to graphic. And now you can see that we have a dedicated track for our captions. And then you can now go ahead to add the animations you want. But let's say I'm cool with what I have so far. I can just go ahead and export my video. And that's basically it, guys. This is how to add dynamic captions to your videos inside of Premiere Pro. Now, if this video was helpful to you, don't forget to hit the like button and make sure to tap the subscribe button. Turn on all notifications so I get to know whenever I upload another video. If you have any questions, let me know down in the comment section. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one.